The Greek government has narrowly won a key vote of confidence, allowing the Prime Minister to continue his fight for more cuts. Parliament now has to decide whether to impose austerity measures worth billions of euro in order to secure a second EU bailout, a lifeline for the country's paralysed economy. But as Sara Firth reports, people on the streets aren't sharing the government's vision.
It's considered by many to be the birthplace of democracy. But in Greece now, the widening gap between the aims of the people and the government is proving explosive.
We are a mix of people that have not political colours, and we are here all together to say that we cannot be under this pressure. We cannot hold the measures, the economical measures that they take for us without us, and we want to take our lives back.
Demonstrations are held on the central square now on a daily basis, with some of the protests turning violent. But protesters say the suffocating tear gas is nothing compared to the austerity measures that they feel are strangling their economy.
The people are being refused their right to judge what policies are going to be implemented upon them. And, of course, the Greek government is an accomplice to this loss of popular sovereignty. I mean, we're not anymore, in the proper sense, a sovereign country. When the IMF can dictate policies, when the ECB and the European Union and the IMF, the so-called Troika, can come and say, listen, these are the measures you are going to implement, you are going to implement them whether you like it or not, we can say, in a way, we're facing a very peculiar form of dictatorship by the European Union, the European Central Bank and the IMF.
Euro finance chiefs are desperate not to see the first Eurozone sovereign default, and there are rising concerns about the crisis that could trigger throughout Europe.
I think there is a chance of a domino effect if Greece announces a default. And this is the problem, and this is the reason why the Europeans are helping Greece. But in fact, they are helping Greece because they don't want this domino effect and because they want to take all the resources of Greece.
But with 16% of the Greek workforce unemployed and worsening economic conditions, here in Greece, the Eurozone dream, it seems, is over.
If the government won't listen to the people's voice, the Athens will be full of people that they were uprising, and there will be a lot of violence in the streets.
The people have said that when they're turning out onto the streets in their millions and the government continues to push ahead with the proposed measures, well, then they don't have democracy anymore.
The government is trying to govern, but the people refuse to be governed in this way.
Every day, that disconnect becomes more and more dangerous. Well, it's very peaceful up here above the rooftops in Athens, really a world away from what's been happening on the streets recently. The question a lot of people have been asking is just when will Greece reach boiling point? Well, anyone who was on the streets of Athens to witness that violence will know that it's already past that point. The question a lot of people are now asking is really how much further does this go? Sara Firth, RT, Athens.